as we near the end, I return to the beginning when I shared with you that there are two types of memory systems, the explicit and the implicit. And I was saying how naturally the implicit memory works. We walk down the beach, we see a sunset, we naturally remember it. Explicit is more difficult because we're trying to memorize specific, discrete facts. So if this one has an advantage over that, why don't we use what is true about this system to help us improve that system? So let's make our explicit learning tasks more like implicit. How do we do that? Well, we make it an experience. So rather than sitting on a couch studying flashcards, maybe we go through a walk. We go for a walk through the neighborhood talking about math facts, because that is more of an experience. It's an event. Maybe while we're having a meal, we can do that. So it doesn't become a 5-minute sit-down individual study session. It's a real-life experience. Making it social. Many experiences in life are with other people. We can make studying a social event. Maybe we study with a parent, uncle, grandparent, maybe with a younger sibling. Teaching something to a younger sibling or a younger cousin, very powerful. Making an activity, which is something that I said, and that's something I have not mentioned today, making an activity multi-sensory, maybe experimenting with different aromas in the room, different tastes, different textures. Sometimes those sensory details matter a lot to certain learners. So if we can take something that would ordinarily be just a boring individual study, oh, I just have to get this done activity, and turn it into a fun, social, experiential activity with different senses, then we take advantage of the power of the implicit learning to help the explicit learning.